aren't doing too well financially. It's become harder and harder just to make ends meet, much less have the extras we thought we could more or less take for granted as we worked harder, moved up the ladder, and made more money.
I work very hard, lots of hours, and I still can't get the dreams that I want, like buying a house.
I rent a flat, but I wish I could afford a house.
Not enough, plus the little that I've saved and a very small government pension, and it really makes you sweat to get by on things.
I'm making more money now than I have before, although I still don't have any money at the end of the week to do anything with.
I work really hard every day, and it's hard to save money.
After I've paid all my expenses with my paycheck, there just doesn't seem to be anything left.
It's very frustrating to think about these things because, you know, when you're working real hard, you want to see your energies amount to something, and sometimes you feel like it's not within your grasp anymore.
To me, there's no solution.
I don't see a solution to this. I really don't.
No solutions? Don't be too sure. The question really is, how can you still make money and become financially secure in the 80s? Can you make your dreams come true? Well, there are ways. And for the next half hour, we'll meet experts and ordinary people from across the country who have reached their dream. See how you can make it work for you.
Money, how to make it, with Tom Harvey. Alan Silverstein, author of Hidden Profit in Your Mortgage, the Smart Money Guide to Canadian Home Ownership. Sam Allman, real estate investor, author, and lecturer. William Nickerson, real estate investor, author of How I Turned 1,000 into 5 Million in Real Estate. John and Greg Rice, the world's smallest twins who made it big in real estate. And Tom Vu, lecturer, author of the Profit, Profit, Profit seminars, the man who's setting new trends on how to make money in the 80s.
The first and most obvious question about making money is how. If you happen to have some money, you normally think of things like stocks, bonds, life insurance, savings accounts, a little real estate, perhaps even gold or precious gems. But what if you have no money? Or worse, no credit. Maybe you're out of work, you've no income. Now, how in the world can you even begin to make your dreams come true under such circumstances? Only about 2% of us retire in luxury or even real comfort, financially secure, independent, living the good life. Most, about 98%, live out their so-called golden years in some degree of poverty. Official poverty, on welfare, trying to exist on government pension, or dependent on relatives. Not a pretty picture, is it? Well, it does not have to happen to you. So what are your problems? What's keeping you from beginning to make sure your dreams come true? Well, even though you might be tempted to think there is nothing you can do about it, but the problem is just too complicated, there are experts who do understand and can explain how you can build financial success and security.
Our father was probably the hardest working man that I knew, but he wasn't able to accumulate much as far as monetary things are concerned because he didn't realize that there are two different kinds of work. There's hard work, and there's smart work. People have to realize that there is another way to make money if they're just willing to go out and learn those ways.
People have all kinds of reasons or excuses for not getting ahead or even wealthy.
I'm not rich because I had a bad basic education.
I'll never get rich unless I win a lottery or something.
I don't think I have a good chance of, you know, getting rich because of the financial situation right now, the jobs and everything.
Me get rich?
I'll never get rich. I'll just get by.
I don't think I'll ever get rich because I'm not engaged in the work that I did before, and I'm frankly too old to be hired by any of the types of companies that I worked in before.
People use all sorts of excuses why they don't do something with their lives. Can you imagine all the excuses that John and I could have used? We realized early on that excuses don't get you anywhere. I mean, can you imagine the excuses that we could have come up with?
So what do you do if you really desire to get ahead? How do you recognize and take advantage of the opportunities? But what happens if you've no money, or even worse, no credit? You might be surprised by some of the answers.
Most people think that it takes money to make money in this country. It doesn't take money to make money. It takes money to lose money. But if you have no money to begin with, then anything that you make is obviously profit to you. I've met people that say, I had $200,000 and I invested in the stock market, and six weeks later, I was flat broke. Well, that's the prime example that it takes money to lose money. If you never had the $200,000 to start with, you wouldn't have made that investment. But if you're willing to learn the things that it takes to become a success, then you can start with nothing and you can accumulate a lot of money.
How do most people invest their money? Stocks, bonds, golds, jewels? I think most investors would agree that real estate is the best investment for them. In fact, real estate has been responsible for delivering more people to financial freedom, for creating more millionaires than any other investment medium.
To me, the best investment that Canadians can make is in their mortgage. By doing so, they're investing in their homes and in themselves. Not only do they realize astounding savings in terms of interest, but they will also save enormous sums of income tax as well.
Most people think it takes money to make money, but what most people don't know is that it doesn't have to be your money. The conventional way is to take $10,000 and buy a house, and with the passage of years, that house will go up $5,000 or $10,000. With new creative financing techniques, you take that same $10,000 and buy many houses. Remember, many houses will go up at the same rate as one house, but the result will be that instead of earning $5,000 or $10,000, you'll earn $100,000 or $200,000.
John and I made more money in one real estate transaction than our father made in an entire year working in the salary job that he was in. And that's when we realized that, hey, this is probably the vehicle that we've been looking for. This is the key to the success that we'd been dreaming of as children.
When we come back, we'll talk to one of those who not only made it, but is teaching others how to.
The majority of America's richest people made their fortunes in real estate, and many of them did it in bad times. Right now, thousands use the Profit Investment Plan with no speculation, no credit, and with little or no cash. Famous real estate expert Tom Vu wants to show you how to become financially independent in today's economy. Learn the safe, simple, sure way to make money in real estate, even if prices are not going up. Discover the secret to financial freedom at the following free 90-minute seminars.
Monday, October 14th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Constellation Hotel, 900 Dixon Road, Dixon Road at Carlingview Drive, Rexdale. Tuesday, October 15th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Royal York Hotel, 100 Front Street West, across from the Union Station, Toronto. Wednesday, October 16th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Walper Terrace Hotel, 1 King Street West, King and Queen Streets, Kitchener. Thursday, October 17th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Old Mill, 21 Old Mill Road, Queen Elizabeth, Exit South, Kingsway, Toronto. Friday, October 18th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Holiday Inn, Hamilton, 150 King Street East, adjacent to Terminal Tower Shopping Mall, Hamilton.
If you want to become financially successful, you've got to learn from those who are already doing it. I think that poor people should take rich people to lunch, and the poor people should pay for the lunch. And a lot of people say, well, that should be the other way around. I mean, the rich person should pay for the poor people's lunch. Well, what can a rich person learn from someone who's poor, except for maybe the fact that they don't want to be poor anymore? But there's a lot that poor people can learn from rich people. If you really want to become financially independent or successful, you've got to start associating with people who are already doing it.
Recently, our field correspondent, George Redding, met a self-made man who never gave himself any excuses for not getting rich. Tom Vu is a real estate expert who became wealthy.
Tell me, Tom, how did you get started?
When I first came to this country, I was a busboy. I had no money. That's why I had to work hard to support the family. During that time, I always wanted to be a waiter. And the people I worked for kept promising me that they're going to make me a waiter. But the promotion never came. So the first thing I learned out of life is, in order to get ahead, you cannot depend on others to help you. You must depend on yourself. You must always believe that you are in control of your own financial destiny.
Okay, that sounds good. But what's the secret to becoming wealthy?
Here's three steps that I tell people. First, you must set a goal. Maybe you don't want to become a millionaire. You just want to be able to retire and travel. That's fine, as long as you are comfortable with it. Number two is go out there and acquire the correct knowledge. The specific roadmap shows you exactly how to get there. And third, very simple. Just go out there and do it. Everybody have a potential to make a lot of money. But you must set a goal for yourself and do it, because if you aim at nothing, you surely hit it. Just like if you do nothing, you will get nowhere.
Tom, tell me, what's the first question people ask you in your seminars?
During my lectures, people always come to me and ask me what is the best investment around.
Which is?
Now, the answer may be unusual, but I'm going to give you the world's safest investment, an investment in yourself. It's easy to become wealthy in today's economy, but you cannot let banker, broker, insurance salesman do your own thinking for you. You have to learn how to do it on your own. There's only two ways to learn that experience. Is number one is you go through the school of hard knocks, or number two is you learn it through other people's experience to save times and prevent mistakes.
May I give you a little test? It's for your own good, so be as honest as you can. The question is, what do you want out of life? One, I want to be a millionaire. Two, I want to retire and travel. Three, I want enough money to be independent, quit my job, and get away from my boss. Four, I want to turn off the TV and think about it later. Financial security is not for me right now. Let me repeat. I want to be a millionaire. I want to retire and travel. I want enough money to be independent. I'll think about it later. Now, I know this may seem silly, but I'm trying to make a point here. If you answered yes to any of these questions, the experts say you'll never make it. Why? Because your goals are far too vague. Most of you think that number four is the easy way out. Well, you might get some comfort from knowing that we are taught or programmed to fail from the time we start school. Now, just think about that. We're taught just how to make good grades, get a job, save money, and so on. We're not taught the road to financial success. Because if all these things really did work, we would not have the millions of old, poor people who are living proof. The old systems, however well-intentioned, just don't work, especially in today's economy. So you ask yourself, what can I do to turn it around for me?
Short-term education with specific goals, adult education classes, seminars, training in motivation for achieving their goals.
What do these kinds of classes do for you in a relatively short period of time, which can mean a lifetime of financial security? Our experts have given you some idea of how real estate works, and they teach seminars on how to make it work for you. Thousands of people have attended these seminars. Take Charlie Coe, for example. He started with a few hundred dollars and made several thousand dollars profit in less than a week.
I couldn't believe that a person could actually buy and sell real estate with no money, no credit, or no formal education, all of which that I don't have. But since learning the techniques afforded me, I've been able to put thousands of dollars in my pocket on a regular basis.
Sam and Julie Hawkins found this house that was about to be repossessed. They were able to buy it for $24,000 below market value.
Julie and I now enjoy the financial freedom that we've always wanted. In fact, we don't have to worry about Social Security, an 8-to-5 job, but only through security through our own efforts. Best of all, I guess, is the fact that Julie and I can work together and close deals together and spend the time together each and every day enjoying ourselves.
Hollis Durady makes his money by spending lots of time looking for bargain properties that were overlooked by others.
It's a beautiful endeavor, this real estate game, as the advantages are all written for us to enjoy, whereby we can obtain all these properties and keep the profits by not paying taxes. This makes you wealthy. You can pyramid your investment into millions and enjoy it forever.
When we return, more tips from our financial experts.
The majority of America's richest people made their fortunes in real estate, and many of them did it in bad times. Right now, thousands use the Profit Investment Plan with no speculation, no credit, and with little or no cash. Famous real estate expert Tom Vu wants to show you how to become financially independent in today's economy. Learn the safe, simple, sure way to make money in real estate, even if prices are not going up. Discover the secret to financial freedom at the following free 90-minute seminars.
Monday, October 14th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Constellation Hotel, 900 Dixon Road, Dixon Road at Carlingview Drive, Rexdale. Tuesday, October 15th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Royal York Hotel, 100 Front Street West, across from the Union Station, Toronto. Wednesday, October 16th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Walper Terrace Hotel, 1 King Street West, King and Queen Streets, Kitchener. Thursday, October 17th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Old Mill, 21 Old Mill Road, Queen Elizabeth, Exit South, Kingsway, Toronto. Friday, October 18th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Holiday Inn, Hamilton, 150 King Street East, adjacent to Terminal Tower Shopping Mall, Hamilton.
Now, it's clear that good, realistic, and practical education can help you. Our experts explain their views on the trends that work in the 80s.
A lot of people tell Greg and I that the reason that you guys are so successful is because you're lucky. You're just 3 feet tall. And I tell them, hey, wait a minute. I spell luck, W-O-R-K, and find that the harder we work, the luckier we get. And it'll work for you if you're 3 feet tall, 6 feet tall, white, black, green, or paisley print.
Having the courage to get started is probably the toughest thing, to get started to begin with. And the fact that you have other students that you're taking attending in seminar helps to give you that courage. In fact, I used to feel that the nitty-gritty, all the nuts and bolts, that was the only thing that mattered. But now I feel that's only about half the battle. The other half is to help encourage you, give you all these examples and show how other people are doing to encourage you to get off the fence and do something.
My advice to anyone who's interested in gaining financial independence is to get started in real estate investing by first getting an education on what to do. How to invest in that first property is the hardest part of getting started in real estate. And I think reading books, listening to tapes, and going to seminars are probably the best methods to build confidence so that when you buy that first investment property, you know you're doing the right thing.
Real estate is a good investment because everybody needs a place to live. And because of this, real estate will always be in demand. High interest rates in the last few years have created a chronic housing shortage. And it is because of this shortage that housing prices are going to continue to soar. Real estate has high leverage. Leverage means you can control a lot of real estate using very little of your own money.
I'd hate to think of what Greg and I'd be doing if we wouldn't have found real estate. I mean, you know, gosh, maybe we'd have been working in a circus or maybe in the back room of some big accounting office, putting some little figures in the little boxes. It'd be somebody else's little figures in somebody else's little boxes. But being that we found real estate, it's given us the financial security and the financial freedom to go out and do the things that we want to do. You'll have no trouble finding people that'll tell you hundreds of reasons why you can't do something with your lives. John and I had people tell us that when we got into the real estate business. They told us, you guys better not get into that business because people might not take you serious enough. Well, fortunately, we didn't listen to those people. And whenever anybody tells you you can't do something, take a look at them. Are they really as successful as you want to be?
When I began to realize how much money Canadians were paying for interest and how much money they were paying for tax to finance that mortgage, I realized it was necessary to give Canadians a straight bill of goods on ways to save money, way to take advantage of the rules that were out there dealing with mortgages and to put money back into Canadians' pockets.
Tell me, what is the best way to invest in the 80s?
In order to successfully invest in the 80s, you have to buy bargain properties. Let me show you what I mean. The major trend in real estate in the 1960s was location, location, location. The trend in the 1970s was terms, terms, terms. It didn't matter how much you pay for your property as long as you got your terms. Sure. That just doesn't work anymore. The new trend in real estate is profit, profit, profit. So you don't have to wait 5 years for profit anymore when you can have it immediately. That's why I advocate buying bargain properties. Bargain properties does not have to be a rundown property. When I said bargain properties, I mean in terms of price. Buying a nice piece of property at below market value provides you with two opportunities. First, you can resell it to make an instant cash profit. Or number two, you can hold on to it and it will immediately increase your net worth. Today's economy offers the greatest opportunity in 50 years to buy real estate at bargain prices. So the time to start is now.
Bargain price real estate is a great investment because you're buying below market value, usually 20 to 30%, sometimes even 50% below the true market value of the property. And the reason that bargain price real estate is such a great investment is you get your profit going into the property. And if you decide to make a quick turnaround and resell it within a month or two, that's fine. Or if you want to hold it for a long period of time, you've already got your profit built in, even though the property may not rapidly appreciate in value for another year or two. But you've got that profit locked in by buying bargain price real estate right up front.
In this crazy economy that we're in today, there are still some excellent buys in real estate. And when I'm talking about good buys in real estate, I'm not talking about going and buying some rundown house somewhere that needs a lot of work, because Greg and I certainly can't do that. We couldn't do that. Can you imagine me trying to paint a house like that? I might do a great job from the doorknob level down, but who would appreciate a paint job like that? What we try to do is we try to go out and find distressed sellers, not distressed properties.
I'm often asked, why don't more people get into real estate investment, since it has proven to be such a worthwhile and safe investment? Most of them, it's fear. People are afraid to do something different. And the only way they can overcome that fear is to get a bigger education, either through books or attending seminars. This helps to give them the courage to go ahead and do something about it.
There are many people in this world who aren't where they'd like to be financially, and it's not because any of them ever planned to fail. It's just that most of them fail to plan. And it's just that simple. You see, there's no magic secret to getting rich. You just got to learn how to do it and then go out and do it.
We'll be back to summarize after these messages.
The majority of America's richest people made their fortunes in real estate, and many of them did it in bad times. Right now, thousands use the profit investment plan with no speculation, no credit, and with little or no cash. Famous real estate expert Tom Vu wants to show you how to become financially independent in today's economy. Learn the safe, simple, sure way to make money in real estate, even if prices are not going up. Discover the secret to financial freedom at the following free 90-minute seminars.
Monday, October 14th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Constellation Hotel, 900 Dixon Road, Dixon Road at Carlingview Drive, Rexdale. Tuesday, October 15th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Royal York Hotel, 100 Front Street West, across from the Union Station, Toronto. Wednesday, October 16th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Walper Terrace Hotel, 1 King Street West, King and Queen Streets, Kitchener. Thursday, October 17th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Old Mill, 21 Old Mill Road, Queen Elizabeth, Exit South, Kingsway, Toronto. Friday, October 18th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Holiday Inn Hamilton, 150 King Street East, adjacent to Terminal Tower Shopping Mall, Hamilton.
If you want to save money, it's simple. Buy a house and make the mortgage payments. Your return will be better than any savings account. Or better yet, rent it out and let someone else make the mortgage payments for you.
Canadians don't think of a mortgage as a source of an investment, but stand back and think. The mortgage enables you to purchase a property, and then if you can put money towards it, you increase your interest in the property that much more quickly. The sooner you pay it off, the sooner you own the house free and clear. So a mortgage is definitely a great source of investment because you're investing in yourself.
I think anyone who's renting now, unless they're just going to be in the region for a very short time, should make plans to buy their personal residence, because renting just means they're wasting their money on rent that's never going to produce a return. I've never known anyone who gets rich from renting, but I do know a lot of people who've gotten very, very wealthy by owning real estate, starting with their first home and then moving on to investment property, such as apartments, offices, commercial property, or as I do, buying rental houses.
There are many ways to make money in real estate. John and I know from personal experience that one way is to buy when property values are down and hold on to them till they increase in value. But the important thing is that you take advantage and you do buy. Because a lot of people sit around and wait and they say, well, I'm going to wait till the prices change, till they come down or whatever. And those are the ones that will sit around and say, I could have bought that property for $10,000 an acre, and today it's selling for $100,000 an acre. 10 years from now, they'll be saying the same thing, except the numbers will just be a little different.
By understanding the rules of the mortgage game and then taking advantage of those rules, really playing the game and knowing the strategy of the game, which bankers know already and which consumers are starting to learn about, they can realize all of these savings which are going to put money in their pocket.
Some people ask, well, if it's so easy the way you talk, it sounds real easy, and you know all these people that are doing it, why doesn't everybody do it? Well, you do have to have certain attributes. I say you only need average savings, average luck, but you do need to have the ambition to want to get ahead. Some people just don't give a damn. They're not concerned with getting ahead, and that's their privilege. But if you want to get ahead, and follow my suggestions, it's pretty hard for you to miss. The other attributes you need the courage to get off the fence and do something about it.
Every day, people stand at the crossroads of life. They have to make the decision on which way to go. Most people go down the same road that they went down yesterday because they know that's safe. But a few people stand there and they make the decision. They make the decision to make change in their lives, to try uncharted paths. Those are the people that are actually going out and making change in their lives. The important thing is that you make the decision to do it now.
Now, what have we learned here today? Well, first, you must set goals. Second, you must make plans, long-range plans. And third, you must learn how to implement those plans. Go to classes, seminars, lectures, read books, and finally, just go out and do it.
The majority of America's richest people made their fortunes in real estate, and many of them did it in bad times. Right now, thousands use the profit investment plan with no speculation, no credit, and with little or no cash. Famous real estate expert Tom Vu wants to show you how to become financially independent in today's economy. Learn the safe, simple, sure way to make money in real estate, even if prices are not going up. Discover the secret to financial freedom at the following free 90-minute seminars.
Monday, October 14th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Constellation Hotel, 900 Dixon Road, Dixon Road at Carlingview Drive, Rexdale. Tuesday, October 15th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Royal York Hotel, 100 Front Street West, across from the Union Station, Toronto. Wednesday, October 16th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Walper Terrace Hotel, 1 King Street West, King and Queen Streets, Kitchener. Thursday, October 17th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Old Mill, 21 Old Mill Road, Queen Elizabeth, Exit South, Kingsway, Toronto. Friday, October 18th at 2 and 8 p.m. at the Holiday Inn, Hamilton, 150 King Street East, adjacent to Terminal Tower Shopping Mall, Hamilton.